Hi everyone, this is Xiaojun Bei on Instagram, and welcome back to another video. It's time for my monthly yapping session, and we have a lot of things to put away today. A total of 118 photo cards, 9 postcards, and 5 decorated top loaders. We're starting off with some decorated top loaders today, which are just so pretty. I was gonna put some of these photo cards that I used in the top loaders away in my collect book, but I realized that they fit the top loader designs, so I stored them here instead. I somehow managed to accumulate a lot of cards again this month, and I think that most of it came from all the cards that I bought on Sandry. From what I can remember, I think I mostly got Taeyeon, Red Velvet, and Animex cards from there. That haul video is a separate one from my monthly mail opening videos because I have about 30 to 40 minutes of raw footage alone. But I haven't had the time to edit it recently because I've been busy with the last few weeks of my graduating semester. I always prioritize editing and uploading these monthly videos because I don't want to accidentally end up uploading a little too late into the month. And the storing photo cards video always takes extra long just because of how much I talk. But it's also really fun, so I don't mind. You might also see me putting away some cards that I already had in my binders in previous videos. I took them out initially to trade or sell because I bought some extras on Sandry. So here I am putting them away again after the ones I bought came in, which included quite a few Chongma and Sugi photo cards, if I remember correctly. Also, flipping through these binders again after putting away all the inserts that I sleeved previously is also satisfying. It just makes everything look extra pretty, but also takes up a lot of space and causes my binders to be a lot more bulky. Because of that, I have plans to separate some of my larger collections like Taeyeon, Red Velvet, and Xiaojun into different binders, which will hopefully arrive in my next haul from Sandry and Taobao. So this would free up some space in my usual Muji binders, and I'm hoping to be able to free up a binder to separate my 80s and Seungyoon collections, which are also both in the same overflowing binder. I actually wanted to get another Muji binder, but I couldn't find them being sold anywhere. So I'm not sure if they're just not selling it now, like if they've just removed it from their sales catalog temporarily, or if it's being discontinued. I used to be really stubborn and insisted on having all of my binders match, but now it's a little impossible given how many collections I have, so I decided to work around it and get some pretty binders as well. The pretty binder that I plan to use for Kiss of Life should also arrive as well. And then I can finally organize my Kiss of Life collection instead of still keeping their cards in the huge box that I have. It's wild how they're about to have their third album release, and yet here I am with their cards not organized yet at all. Now, it's time for some other life updates, which basically means my nail polish shades and the dramas I've watched in March. And I'll pause here and there if we get to a part where I actually need to talk about the cards being shown. I pretty much only use Hollow Taco nail polishes, and I painted my nails 3 times in March. I used the shade Dialer the Cat for my first set, then did 1 Melon Followers and also added Celestial Lights on my accent nails for my second set. But my eczema has been a little bad recently, and I felt like my nails were just getting too long and not really helping my eczema. So I only had my second set of nails on for a week before I took my nails short again and painted them. But I was a little distracted while cutting my nails and accidentally took them too short plus did the wrong shape. So I actually absolutely hate my nails right now. Although the shade I have on right now, I'm Overbrew with Gold Flake Taco on my accent nails, is super stunning, and this is the set I usually do over Chinese New Year since it is very festive. Painting it was such a chore because my polish actually got contaminated, which made it very difficult to work with. But I'll just leave it on for now while my nails grow out, and I'm hoping that they would have grown enough for me to reshape and redo before I leave for my trip at the end of April, where I'm traveling to Taiwan with my friend, This time, I have so many Yena photocards to put away, mostly from her Good Morning era. I actually have some more on the way because I joined a group order for her Poka albums, and also this really cute pre-order benefit of hers where she's posing with a strawberry, and I love strawberries. So I caved and just had to get it. Once those Poka albums come in, I can also finally edit and upload my Good Morning era video. I thought it would be just a really quick album unboxing video, but it ended up being a lot more because I kept joining orders. Speaking of joining orders, the damage that would be done to my bank account because of Kiss of Life's Midas, I'm not sure how to pronounce it yet, oops, touch era is insane. I've only purchased things for their photo book, but they also have jewel cases and Poka albums this time. I'm waiting a little longer for more pre-order benefits to be released so I can get the albums and inclusions at a cheaper price. But wow, there's a lot going on this era, but each album unfortunately comes with less photocards in it now. But I guess they're replacing a selfie photocard with a unit photocard, which will be cute as well. I also read a book for one of my assignments in March, which is pretty special to me since the author of the book is Kiss of Life's Julie's brother, Joseph Han. It was a pretty interesting read, and I just quickly read the book first before I had to return it to the library, although I haven't started working on the assignment. The due date for the assignment is actually during my Taiwan trip, so I really should finish that assignment before I fly off. Although, technically, I will be traveling with my laptop, so I can work on it while I'm there. Drama-wise, I finished The Last Immortal, Shen Yin, in the first week of March. I finished Everybody Loves Me, 别对我动心, which explains why I was talking about Lin Yi to my friend every week during class. I enjoyed the drama a lot. I'm still thinking about whether I want to watch his new drama, Angels Fall Sometimes, 谢谢你温暖我, which I've heard is absolutely devastating, and I do not think I have the emotional capacity to handle that right now, on top of everything else going on in my life right now. Meanwhile, my Chang'e collection has made huge progress. Apart from her latest release with Inni Mini, now I'm just left with two cards from her Hands On Me era, which explains why it's so hard to find since that's her solo debut era. I've been prioritizing buying cards that will help me finish my collections, and talking about this also reminds me that I haven't updated my Chang'e wishlist with her new photo cards yet. I've been a little busy lately that I forget that with new releases comes new photo cards as well. Okay, now back to my drama talk. While painting my nails, I also started a drama that was on my plan to watch list, but I didn't really remember why I added it in. The drama is called Warm on a Cold Night, 九霄寒夜暖. It's a costume drama, 古装剧, which I find the slower pacing better for when I paint my nails and can't really pay as much attention to the drama at all times. Turns out, the drama is basically a wolf boy drama. Yes, the male lead is a wolf. Which may be the reason why I added it to my list. I can't even remember because now, even after finishing the drama, I don't know what clip or what review I saw that prompted me to add it to my list. Well, on episode 30 out of 36 for that drama, did I realize that the female lead was being played by Lee Yi Tong. That's the female lead in Go-Go Squid Season 2, the drama that I dropped halfway through, which really goes to show how bad I am with recognizing faces. I checked her filmography, I hope that's the term, out, and found out she also had a role in Love Between Fairy and Devil, Changlandre. But I feel like I don't really remember that drama that well anyway, which could explain why I don't remember seeing her face before. After finishing that drama, I started on Amidst a Snowstorm of Love, 在暴雪时分. I'm almost done with it. I'm on episode 27 out of 30 right now, and I absolutely understand why this drama is so loved by so many people. I think that it's a drama that I will think about for a very long time to come, and will also rewatch many times in the future because they are just so green flag coded that it makes me feel like love is actually real and possible. Like, they look at each other with so much love in their eyes that it makes me think that, wow, maybe it is possible for someone to love another that much. I think that I will always have this hope in my heart when I think of this drama. This is the second Ule drama I'm watching. I watched it in The Long Ballad, Changge Sing, and I'm still deciding whether or not to watch Love Like the Galaxy, Xing Han Chan Lan, Yue Sheng Chang Hai, which he acts with Zhao Lu Si in. I probably will because of how much I enjoyed the two dramas I've watched of him. This is also the second Zhao Jinmai drama I'm watching, but I feel like the first one that I watched, The Blessed Girl, Ling Long, which she acted with Lin Yi in, doesn't really count because I don't remember anything about that drama, and it was also kind of mid, and I don't even remember recognizing Lin Yi in that drama. After this, I'll probably go and watch Reset, Kai Duan, which she acted in with Bai Jingping. I remember wanting to watch Reset when it first released, which again, I never really got around to. Although by that time, I already knew of both the lead actors since I watched Bai Jingping in You Are My Hero, 你是我的成痴英雷. I hope I said that correctly, to be honest, which I also really enjoyed. Anyways, this goes to show how everything is full circle and I will get to watching all the dramas that I want eventually. Maybe a few months or years late, but we'll get there. I don't know what I want to prioritize watching after I'm done with Amidst a Snowstorm of Love, 在暴雪时分. I'll probably not be able to get over that drama for a while, but I'll be sure to give updates on my drama watching adventures in my next yapping video. For Red Velvet, my biggest accomplishment is that I've now finally finished my finale collection, with many thanks to my dear friend at Yeziwei on Instagram, who I also run this channel with, who got me the Sewing Machine Irene card as a present for when we did Secret Santa last year. I've also made quite some progress with Chillkill, especially after I put both sets in my bag albums. I also absolutely love having Red Velvet inserts in my collection because they are just so stunning. Thank you. I'm also absolutely in love with this Shotaro photo card I got. I'm so glad that I was made aware of this amazing photo card where Taro is holding a taro milk tea. Honestly, I have to try and limit myself so much with his cards because he is just so cute that I want everything. But this card in particular is extra cute. Fun fact, my Instagram username was originally going to be Shotaro and milk tea related, but I ended up with Xiaojinbei to match with Yezibei. And now I have the username Shotaro Pearl saved for a different account where I post my PSAs when dealing with shitty people. I also recently got my first Keita photo card, finally. That makes me so happy. For Wavy, I've also finally finished my Phantom collection. That last 10 photo card took a while to arrive and kickstarted my On My Youth collection with one, a singular Xiaoxin photo card. But hey, at least it counts. For Cherry Bullet, I got the last 3 Haeyun photo cards that I needed, which means that I finished her collection for now, and honestly for the foreseeable future, cause I don't see them making a comeback anytime soon. For NMIX, I managed to make some more progress with my Lily collection, which makes me so happy because I am such a sucker for her pink hair. I also got a bunch of Dreamy cuts in an attempt to finish up my NCT collection, but with member pricing and everything, Jisung's cut were too expensive for me to get, so I guess I'll have to wait a little longer before finishing that collection up. Flipping through my 80s collection, which already feels so full, but I still have so many missing photo cards. I really want to get a bunch of cards in bulk, but I'm trying to hold back on my spending because of my upcoming trip. actually plan to move my G-Idle collection into a separate binder as well, and go through their albums that are on my shelf and store their inserts too. I've been trading for so many of their cards recently, plus I got some pulls from the 2 era, which amounted to a whopping 20 cards for me to put away today. I actually haven't started for the trading for the 2 era either, because I've been so busy. Otherwise, I probably would have had a lot more to put away. Today, I also finally decided to get around to organizing my Le Sserafim collection and properly section them, instead of just chucking whatever cards I got away into the pages, because I have a bunch of cards from the Easy era. I ran out of filler white sleeves in the end, but I think that problem will be solved hopefully the next time I put away cards, and can free up some sleeves to use. But if I intend to stick to my minimal spending plan in order to set aside some money to spend while on my trip, what if I end up in a situation where I only have like 5 cards to put away in April or something? I'm not sure what I'd do at that point. I'd probably have to wait until the month after or something, right? Because a video of me putting away like 5 cards will probably only be 5 minutes long, and I won't be bothered to film that if that's the case. I realized that I only have 2 Chaewon cards in comparison to my Yunjin and Kazuha collection. And I actually had another Chaewon card on the way, but I think it got lost over the holidays since we arranged for that trade in November 2023. There's another mail from around that time that hasn't arrived yet either. So I should probably get to updating my wish list and searching for those cards again. I also ended up keeping this Inche card that I got for my internal trading pool, just because it's so pretty. I was considering putting it in my collect book, but I quickly looked through my extra decorated top loaders and realized that this one could fit quite well too. So that's what I did, and with that, that's the end of my storing photo cards video for March 2024. I hope you enjoyed the video, thank you so much for watching. Bye bye!